What do they say? Find a penny, pick it up, and all the day you'll have good luck. Unless, of course, you ever want to try and spend it.
Locals in Ventnor on the Isle of Wight will tell you that back in the 70s there were 13 public toilets in the town, but today all but one are closed.
Where can I go?
Despite being one of the UK's top tourist destinations, the number of public loos on the island has fallen by around 40% in just 3 years. And it's a similar tale in most of our towns and cities. Councils don't have to provide public loos, and with cuts being demanded from Whitehall, if it's not a statutory service, then it's at risk. Dave Small says finding a loo on the island is getting harder and harder.
Gradually, the county council seen to it that they're all slowly disappearing. And people think, they think people don't notice if things happen slowly. But people live a long life. Over 10 years, you can look back and say, oh, that was there once. Or, oh, I wish we had that still. And toilets are one of the main things that are going. You can't find one now. There's lots of street signs saying toilets. But when you go for them, they're a house or they're a wall. They're not toilets.
Where can I go?
Here in Portsmouth, the council is proposing to close more than half the public toilets across the city in an effort to save hundreds of thousands of pounds.
Currently in Portsmouth, we spend over £500,000 a year providing public loos around the city. But I think we can probably do it better, we can do it smarter. And the reality is that this year I have to make £17 million worth of cuts at the council here in Portsmouth because the government have withdrawn funding. And we have to look at everything. And some things, like children in care, people with real disabilities, we have to protect those. Those are the most vulnerable people. And we'll try to keep as many public loos in Portsmouth open as we possibly can.
People are currently being asked what they make of the plans for fewer loos.
We've come to visit Portsmouth. That we know where the toilets are. And if they cut them by half, yes, I think I might be in a bit of trouble.
You can't find public toilets these days. It's, and I mean, it's one of the essential things of life, isn't it? So they use a toilet.
People need toilets if they're out all day, don't they? So, you know, it's obvious to keep them open, isn't it?
Yeah.
We walk a lot every day. So if you're out all day, what do you do?
What do you do?
Exactly. Yeah. So don't close them.
Ever since Queen Victoria was on the throne, public toilets have been part of the landscape of our towns and cities. But as more and more vanish, there are voices warning of a risk to public health.
I don't think there are councils anywhere who want to be doing this, particularly in metropolitan urban areas where there are concentrations of people. They know the dangers. Don't forget, environmental health services are also being cut at the same time. So standards of public health are being trimmed away by the day. Won't be long before we're throwing our slops out of the window and shouting Gardy Low.
In the short term, more public toilets across the south look set to close as councils struggle to make savings. Finding a loo that's open will more than ever be just the ticket.